Namaskar girls. Till now we have start learning the 7th unit Indian economy. The previous classes we learned the status, isn't it? What are the two status of the countries? One is developed, the another one is developing. And also we learned the features of the high developed countries. What are all the characteristics or the features? That is high national income, high consumption power, and high employment, isn't it? So we learn the features of developed countries. And then we learn the Indian economy, that what are all the things are strength for the Indian economy, and also we learn what are all the weakness of Indian economy. And then we have learned the demographic trends. In that we learn birth rate, death rate, literacy, isn't it? And then sex ratio, everything we learned in the demographic terms. Today we are going to learn natural resources. Usually while we studied about the features of developed countries, we learn they use the resources in the optimum level, isn't it? Maximum the resources will be utilized for the production purpose. So it is necessary to learn what are all the resources are available in India. What are all the natural resources? What do you mean by natural resources? In your previous classes from 4th standard onwards we have learned, isn't it? What are all natural resources? Natural resources are nothing but they are the gift of nature. It is created by God, we usually say that, isn't it? It is not a man-made thing. It is already available in the nature. So while we are studying about the natural resources, we not only consider the minerals or things, we also consider the land, rivers, all the water bodies, even trees. Everything will be included in the natural resources. Usually while we are talking natural resources, immediately we think about petroleum, coal and other things which is available under the ground. But not only that, natural resources also include land, water bodies, trees, even the environment. Everything is included in the natural resources. So while we are studying the natural resources, we ought to study the two types of natural resources. One is renewable and another one is non-renewable. These things also you have studied in your earlier classes, isn't it? What do you mean by renewable? That is the resources that can be regenerated in a span of time, isn't it? Which can be regenerated or reproduced. At a particular period of time, they can reproduce or regenerate. That is called renewable. Non-renewable, which cannot be regenerated, which cannot be reproduced. For example, for the first one, we can consider the forest, wind, hydro energies or renewable resources. Non-renewable resources, fossil fuel, coal, petroleum, minerals and other things are non-renewable. Once the production or the things were taken from the ground, it cannot be reproduced, it cannot be regenerated. So natural resources is a gift of nature, and we have two types of natural resources, that is renewable and non-renewable. And renewable resources means which can be regenerated in a span of time or a particular period of time. Non-renewable, which cannot be regenerated. Under the heading of natural resources, we are going to study land, forest and important minerals. So land is one of the natural resources, forest and also the minerals which is available under the soil, under the ground. The first one is land resources. Why you are considered the India in the area wise, it occupies 32.8 square kilometers in the total world area. So India occupies 32.8 lakh square kilometers. That means one third, isn't it? Almost it's a big. And if you consider in the percentage, it is 2.42% of total world area. Though India is a very big country, there is a density, isn't it? Because of the high population, India ranks second next to China. So, because of a high population, India is densely populated. And if you consider the agricultural census, large holdings decline, and because of the fragmented and become ineconomic. World level, the agricultural area is also comparatively big in India, large size, but because of the marginal holding and fragmentations, dividing systems, the area has been declined nowadays. And then second resources is forest resources. So in the year 2007, India covers 69.09 million hectare in the total world area of forest. That is 21.02% of the total geographical area. And among this, 8.35 million is dense forest. Totally 69.09. Of this, 8.35 million hectare is dense forest. No one can enter. This is a dense forest. It is only the home of the animals and others, living creatures. And the rest, and 31.90 is moderate forest, and the rest is remaining, the rest part is open forest. So total area of forest is 69.09 million hectare. Of this, 8.35 million hectare is dense forest. And the next one, we are going to learn the important mineral resources. The important mineral resources we are going to learn 7 minerals, that is iron ore, coal and lignite, bauxite, mica, crude oil, gold and diamond. The first one is iron ore. India possesses high quality iron ore in abundance. So India is the largest producer of iron ore. The total reserves of iron ore in the country, 40.6 million tons. 14.630 million tons of hematited and 10,619 million tons of magnetite. Hematite iron is found in Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, Odisha, Goa and Karnataka. The major deposit of the magnetite iron is available in the west coast of Karnataka, and also some deposits iron ore also found in Kerala, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu also. And the second one is coal and lignite. Already you all know Neyveli, isn't it? NLC, Lignite Corporation. So it is the largest available mineral resources. Coal is one of the largest minerals available resources in India. And it ranks third in the world after China and USA in coal production. Well, the first producer, coal producer is China, and the second one is USA, and the third is our country, India. So India ranks third in the coal production in the world. And coal is also found in West Bengal, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. And bulk of coal production comes from Bengal, Jharkhand coal fields. So large amount comes from Bengal. And the third is bauxite. Bauxite is the main source of the metal like aluminium. Bauxite is a metal source, main source of metal like aluminium. It is available in Odisha and Andhra Pradesh. And mica, the next one is mica, which is considered to be the heat resisting mineral. It is considered to be the heat resisting mineral, and also it is considered to be a bad conductor of electricity. And India ranks first in the production of mica. From the world total production, 60% of the production is given by India. Almost more than 50%, it is almost total among the 100%, 60% we are producing. So India ranks first in the production of mica. And it contributes 60% to the world's production. And the important mica bearing pegmatite. It is found in Andhra Pradesh, Jharkhand, Bihar and Rajasthan. Pegmatite means rough, porous, crystallized rock. That is pegmatite. Rough crystal rock. It is found in Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan and Jharkhand. And the next one is crude oil. It has explored in India many places like Assam and Gujarat. It is found in Assam and Gujarat. Digboi, Bhartpur, Nagatya, Kashimpur, Palaria, Rudrapur, Shivasagar, Moon, all the places are there in Assam, and also Ankaleshwar and Kalol in Gujarat are the important places of oil exploration in India. So they have given the names of the places where it is available. And the next one is gold. Only limited resources of gold is available in India. So, India possesses a limited gold reserve because you already know where the gold is available. Have you remembered girls? Kolar. Kolar and Jhawan. Kolar gold field. It is one of the places where gold is digging. Gold digging is here, and in Kolar district and Raichur district, Kutti gold field. So only three places gold is gold mines are there only in three places in India. The one is Kolar, the second one is Hathi, and third one is Ramgiri. Ramgiri gold field, which is in Anandpur district. So these are the three places where gold mines, that is Anandpur is in Andhra Pradesh. So India possesses only a limited gold resources. And the last one is diamond. The last one is diamond. As per the United Nations data, total reserve of diamond is estimated around 4582 carats. The last one is diamond. The total reserve of diamond is estimated
around 4,582,000 carats, which are available in Madhya Pradesh and Karnool districts of Andhra Pradesh and the basin of Krishna's river. And they have given the name of the districts where the varieties are available. And with this, we have completed the natural resources. That is, three resources we have learned. First one is land, the second one is forest, and the third one is important mineral resources. In that minerals, we learned iron ore, coal and lignite, bauxite, mica, crude oil, gold and diamond. The next one we are going to learn, infrastructure. How the infrastructure helps a country for the development or for the growth. That we are going to see in the next video. Thank you, girls.